Hi, my name is Jim Oswald of Sierra Instruments, and I'm the tech support supervisor. And today we're talking about our Model 810 mass flow controller. And in this segment, I'm going to show you what you can access through these two front holes in the front panel. Okay, the little front door on this controller has two holes in it. And you use a small screwdriver to access the zero adjust and the set point adjust. This is if it's in the mode to accept this as your control signal, which I'll show you how to do. So through the holes, you don't need to remove this front cover. If you want more control and you want more of life, you can take the front off, and inside, of course, here's the two potentiometers. I'm going to call them pots. The two pots over here that I told you about a moment ago, the top one being zero, and the bottom one being the set point. You can do those with the door off if you want, but be careful, there are other pots in here that do other things. If you're the kind of person who wants to calibrate this device and you have a primary standard that you trust in terms of flow, you can do so with these other pots in here on this side. And our tech support department can send you a diagram of what they are, and you could calibrate your own meter section of this controller. In the middle, these two rows of five pins here are test points. You'll see that in your manual, and it will describe what each one is. You won't normally use these. You won't normally have the front off of this, actually. And then perhaps the most important thing is over here on this side. I'm pointing now at what we call dip switches, DIP. And there's a bank of five of them. The sixth one at the bottom is not used. But the top five are configured by you or us at the factory, or both, to tell the controller what set point source you're going to give it. You could configure these for internal source, which means this little pot over here, the bottom one, is going to control the flow. Or you can configure it for a voltage coming in through the external wires, or a milliamp current coming in through the external wires. So there's eight different possible settings. If you want to use this over here, remember this must be configured for internal source. Sometimes we get calls and people say this pot isn't working to control the device, and so immediately we'll have them check their dip switches, and lo and behold, they're set for an external source signal. How do you know what yours comes from the factory as? Well, you go to your label. This one happens to say set signal 4 to 20 milliamps. So we will have already configured those little switches to receive a 4 to 20 milliamp signal from outside the device through the wires. So if you tried to use that onboard pod, it wouldn't work until you change those dip switches. But these are handy to know that they're there in case you want to operate this in a local fashion and you just want to check it out. Then you can remove the cover, switch to internal, and then over here you can use the bottom pot to control the flow. And so thanks for watching today about our Model 810 mass flow controller. If you have any further questions, we do pride ourselves in our technical support, and you can contact us through our website, which is sierrainstruments.com, or call us on our tech line at the factory at 800-866-0200, and we'll help you out if we can. Again, thanks for using our equipment.